Hi and welcome! If you are like most developers, you're probably focused on the gameplay mechanics and visuals of your game. And those are super important. But don't forget that your game's text can also make a big impact on the overall player experience. That is why today I'll be showing you how to get started with TextMesh Pro, and how to level up your text UI skills from there. This tutorial comes with a few chapters. We will first look at how to install and set up TextMesh Pro. Then we will go over the core features it offers in the inspector, the settings you can customize to speed up your workflows, followed by how to create a custom font and how to reference a TextMesh Pro component via script and set its contents with code. Once these basics are covered, I'll show you a few more advanced features. I have a big playlist on TextMesh Pro and made videos on many of TMP's use cases and features you might enjoy, like using sprites inside text boxes, styling your text with materials, or making text clickable. The setup. If you're working with the current version of Unity, TextMesh Pro comes with it by default. Just right-click in your hierarchy, UI, Text TextMesh Pro. Alternatively, if you need your text to appear inside the game instead of the UI, for example for damage indicators, you can create that by right-clicking your hierarchy, 3D object, Text TextMesh Pro. If you're working with an older version of Unity, you can find TMP at Window, Package Manager, Unity Registry, TextMesh Pro. If you got it a few years back when it had been an Asset Store plugin, do not use that anymore. It hasn't been updated in quite some time now. The first time you create a TMP object, you will get asked what to import. You need to click this upper button to get the core setup for TextMesh Pro created in your project. And the second button will import a bunch of examples on what to do with TextMesh Pro. I recommend having a look at them, but you don't need to import them into every project you create. The TMP component. Alright, we have our first TextMesh Pro game object. In your hierarchy, it will be named Text TMP. In comparison, legacy text is being named Text Legacy. We find a basic text area at the top and many useful styling features under Main Settings. We can set the font we want to use, style it in bold, italic, and many more typical font styles like uppercase and lowercase. These options will always apply to the whole text being displayed, but there are options to only, for example, bold parts of your text. I'll get to that in a moment. Obviously, we need a font size, and we are also getting offered a checkbox for auto text size. This will change the size of the text based on the space available and amount of text you want to display. I am generally not a fan of this and would advise you to find a font size that works for all the text you want to display in this text box. And of course, we get an option to pick the vertex color. That's the font's color. TextMesh Pro offers super useful spacing options. Especially line and character can help you design your text to be much more readable. If your text is long enough and contains paragraphs, I highly recommend using the paragraph spacing as well. Don't overdo it though. Too much and your text will become visual clutter most won't bother to read. Wrapping is enabled by default, and I haven't come across a use case for disabling that. Overflow, on the other hand, is super useful depending on your use case. Overflow is set by default, and you can see the result in the scene. The text box has a yellow outline, and our text is being displayed in full, even though the text box itself is way too small for it. Usually, you would just resize your box to the desired size and most likely shorten your text to be displayed. Under Extra Settings, you can find the always useful margins and a toggle for raycast target. If you do not need your text to be clickable, you can toggle it off here. Text styles, material presets, overflow methods, sprite and style sheets and style sheet assets are things I will come to in the last part of this video. There are amazingly useful features of TextMesh Pro, but I would consider them to be things you might enjoy most after understanding the basics first. Creating a font asset. to create a font asset you can use with TextMesh Pro, import a font into your project. It should be an OpenType font or a TrueType font. Right-click on it, create TextMesh Pro font asset. Alternatively, Shift-Control-F12 works as well. You can drop this new asset into your textbox component and style it any way you want. Please be aware that if you have a font and want to bold it or have it being displayed in italic, you can click on the buttons, but if you haven't also imported and set up the corresponding font styles, TextMesh Pro will use some preset values to mimic the effect of those text styles. The results can range from quite workable to downright ugly. Setting up the correct styles is luckily done in a few minutes. Have a look at this video if you want to utilize font styles in your game and make it look good. Changing text and settings via code. Changing text via code is super simple. In your script, reference the TextMesh Pro component by using TMP text. This way, you get access to all the settings you see in the inspector and a lot more, but let's stick to the basics. Change the text to be displayed by adding .text and setting it to a string like this. The color can be accessed by .color, the font size by .size. Many of the other options can be accessed in a similar manner, corresponding to their names in the inspector. If you need to look up something, I highly recommend having a look at the TMP documentation. The TextMesh Pro settings. You can find TextMesh Pro settings under Edit, Project Settings, TextMesh Pro. Here you can also import the TMP Essentials, as well as the examples and extras if you need the options once more. In Settings, you can set the default font asset, which will be used for every TMP component going forward inside this project. Changing this setting will not change anything in text boxes you created up to this point. Inside the text container default settings, you can set how big you want your default text boxes to be created. I found 200 by 50 to be way too small for most of my use cases and set those numbers to something that fit my project better. Also, you can set the default font size here. The other settings are rather situational, but you might want to revisit them once you got more practice with the basic features. The next level. And these are the core basics. But let's have a look at what you might want to do next. For example, you might want to display some parts of your text in bold, but clicking this button sets your whole text to bold instead. To get your desired result, you need to know about tags. Tags are simple things you add to your string to mark certain parts in a way TextMesh Pro can understand. They won't be displayed to the player. In this case, we want to bold this part of the sentence. To do so, we add a pointy opening bracket, the letter B for bold, and close the bracket. As you can see, the whole text after this tag will now be bolded. To only have it affect the word, we need to close the tag by adding this. These tags are part of the so-called rich text capabilities, and there are dozens of styles you can use. I have created a cheat sheet to look up which common tags there are and what they correspond with. You can find the download site in the comments. Alternatively, TMP's documentation is a great resource. Adding these tags doesn't only work in the inspector, like here, but when you do it in code as well. If your game has grown quite a bit and you suddenly want to change the font asset you use, locating all your text boxes can be a bit of a hassle, especially if you haven't remembered to prefab all of them. I certainly forget some in every project. If you want to prevent running into that problem, I absolutely recommend using so-called text styles. Text styles are one of the mightiest features of TextMesh Pro. You find them in the drop-down right under your text box. The preset ones are rather nonsensical, but in this 6-minute video, I explain how to create your own, set them up, and utilize them inside your project. By using styles, you can change how your texts are being displayed at any moment without having to touch anything inside the components themselves. Plus, you can use styles to have your players change how text is being displayed inside your game too. That one's a bit tricky, to be fair, but you will learn how to utilize it in this video. That one I would only recommend to more seasoned TMP users, though. There is a high chance you want to display sprites in your text boxes. I explain how that works in this roughly 5-minute long video. If you want to show button prompts based on your input method, you will learn how to do so in this one, and if you want your sprites to be animated, you will learn how that works in this third one in the series. Colors and gradients are not enough for what you have in mind? You'd like to have an outline or think about something more custom? For outlines, your first step might be to have a look at the outline settings inside the shader. You can dilate the font by a bit, then check the outline box and set its color and thickness to whatever you like. I would recommend setting the thickness of the outline to the same number as the value you dilated by. That way, your font will keep its initial look best. But working like this will have the side effect of all instances of your font in your project suddenly using these settings. Depending on your project, this might not be a problem at all. But if you want this effect on only some texts or want even more customizability, have a watch of this video about working with gradients, materials, and shaders. You can get awesome looking results with just a few clicks. And if you feel comfortable with writing code and want your text to be able to be interacted with, for example, to display tooltips or descriptions, opening websites or triggering things inside your game when hovering or clicking on certain parts, I have a couple of videos that will teach you how to make it work. You can even have your characters react to your text box's contents by using this approach. If you enjoy cool text effects like shivering or jumping, maybe the paid asset called Text Animator created by Fibucci is something you might enjoy. I certainly do. You can learn all about it in this video. And when it comes to typical use cases for text in games, I made a video on displaying text inside a scrollable text box, as well as one teaching you how to create a book. Lastly, many games today come with the typewriter effect. I made a video on how to create one yourself here, but this might be the most advanced tutorial you can find on my channel for now. Welcome to TextMesh Pro. I hope you enjoyed not only this video, but getting an idea about what you can do with this mighty tool. If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing and giving it a like. You would make my day, honestly. You will find a whole bunch of links in the description and pinned comment. Have a great week!